And every time it rains, pennies from heaven.
Shoo-be-doo-be.
Don't you know each cloud contains pennies from heaven?
Shoo-be-doo-be.
You'll find your fortune falling all over town. Be sure that your umbrella is up, upside down. And trade them for a package of sunshine and ravioli.
Macaroni.
If you want the things you love, you must have a pizza holy, baby. And when you hear thunder, don't run under a tree. There'll be pennies from heaven for you and me. Now come over here, boy, Sam. And every time it rains. And don't you know it's crocodiles? Every time it rains.
Okay, I'll see you next week. I have some points.
Okay.
I would like to welcome everyone to the West Las Vegas Art Center. And we thank you for your support. We really, truly appreciate you. Right now, I would like to present India Oni with Pennies from Heaven. They bring back memories of my mother. Her name is Lily.
That's her over there. I always bring her.
Hi, Mom. She used to tell me, and it was her favorite saying, "Baby, when you're going to need me the most, I'm not going to know what to do." And she's right, as moms are,
after you get older.
Because in 1999, my mother died suddenly from stroke. I needed her so much that day. And ever since. No, maybe it was out of grief or something. I have no idea. But about a month after she passed, I had the worst nightmare. It was horrible. You know the kind, have you ever had the kind when you're trying to walk and your feet are stuck? It's like you're in quicksand and you can't move. And you do everything in your power to get out of that. Well, I started doing all the usual tricks to wake up. And none of them. So, my last ditch attempt of getting up, I had to wake up. I pulled everything inside of me, and I screamed! I was awake, but the nightmare was still there. It was still there, and my feet were stuck in quicksand, and all of a sudden I was in this
deeper and deeper down.
This black and bottomless pit, it was so dark. Light couldn't even penetrate it. I fell into a deep depression, and I couldn't find my way out. I fell until I couldn't read anymore. I fell until I couldn't write anymore. I fell until I could barely speak. I fell until the outside world was scary. And there was monsters that lived out there. And I couldn't leave my house, those monsters. And my whole world condensed until 1,100 square foot apartment. And in that place, I held on to the teeniest thread of reality. And just when I said, you know what? This is it. This is your fate. This is what your life is going to be from now on. This is it. Strangest thing. My art, they found me. My art found me. They came into that dark place and they gathered around me and they held me and they rocked me. And he told me that everything was going to be okay. And they shared their stories with me. And they said, paint those portraits. And when you can, when you're up to it, tell a story. Well, after a while, I slowly gained my grip on reality. Until the day came that they gathered around me again, and I went, uh-oh. Uh-oh. They said, okay, you've been in this place long enough. I think it's time that you go back out into the world. I was like, oh, okay. You go back out in the world, but it's not just for you now. It's not just for you. It's for other people that need to know that there's a way back out. You have to go out there not just for yourself, but for them. So as I slowly ventured out of my safe confinement, my sanctuary, another strange thing happened. I started finding pennies. I started finding pennies everywhere, and I still do. And every time I find a penny, and I think they're from my mom, it's to tell me to hold on, to stay strong, and to never, ever, ever give up on myself.
before you. You see a woman born of nobility and privilege? Yes, it is true that my position grants me this. But it's also true that this is a long and lonely path. A path to a life that I could never call my own. No doubts or misjudgments. I must know the right thing to say, the right thing to do in any and every situation. For you see, my word is truth, justice, life or death. Could you possibly imagine the sheer weight? I must admit that there are times when the serpent of self-doubt finds me, and as he tightens his grip, I lose my mind. In that darkness, I search for the dimmest of lights to guide me. And as tears of shame wet my face, I hear a voice. It's a deep and cavernous voice that comes rolling in from another reality, rolling in from another dimension. Why you were born, my daughter, my child. This is why you were put on this earth. And you will do this.
Yes, Father.
I understand that this represents all those who came before me and all those yet to come. I understand that this represents the past. I understand that this represents the present. I understand that I represent the future of my people.
And then, when I get home, and then I go inside, and then I give her a big hug. And she says, hey, how much do you love your mom? And I go, this much? And she goes, how much do you love your mom? I go, this much. She says, how much do you love your mom? I go, this much. And then she goes, yeah. And then she grabs me, and then she kisses me all over my face like this. And then she asked me about my day, and then I asked her about her day. And cause it's just the two of us. And she always gives me cookies when I get home, or sometimes I get my favorite thing of all, blueberry muffins. Mm-mm, so good. And I put the butter on it. But today when I got home, there was a lot of people in the house. And they wouldn't let me go in the room and talk to my mom. And I said, hey, what's going on? And my auntie was there, and she told me to go in the kitchen for a while. And you know what? There was no cookies or no muffins or nothing when I got there. Nothing. No. And so I said, hey, something's going on. And so you know what I did? I went like this. And I went and I sneaked over to the room like this. And then I peeked in the door like this. And then there was a bunch of people in there. And I saw Mom, and she was laying in the bed. And then my auntie saw me. Ooh, she saw me, and she was mad. And she went over there like this. And then she grabbed me and she put me back in the kitchen. She said, you got to stay in there. And then you know what she did? She put on the TV and the radio. I'm not supposed to look at TV until after I finish my homework. So I said, hey, is Mom okay? And she said, yeah. She said that she's sleeping with some angels. Is that it? I see angels all the time. They're real pretty and they fly around like this. They're not like a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle. They're not the same like them, but they fly around and they got colors and stuff. So I was like, if you just want Mom to wake up, all you gotta do is let me in the room. I'll go over to her, I'll tap her like this. I'll show her the rock and she'll get up. That's all you gotta do. Cause she loves this kind of stuff. She loves it. And she'll wake up if they let me go in there. Do you listen to your mother? Your mother, the earth. Your mother, Um. It's okay. That baby understands. She tells us. She tells us what we are connected to. But we forgot. 'Cause we don't listen. Because the Mother Womb of the Earth has a spirit. It has a spirit of her own. And everything that's in, on, or above her has a spirit too. From the tiniest grain of sand to the clouds up in the sky, we are all one. From the sickening cries up in the trees to the of the love, we are connected. We are one. Mother Womb told me to ask my brother, the forest. And he will tell you every narrow trail, every hidden path. To ask my sister, the wind. And she will lift you up. And you will hunt as if your feet were seeking the ground. To ask my brother, the night. And he will clothe you. And I will become one. Only of the village that are truly one with the forest, with the spirits, are allowed to build our huts at the very edge. 'Cause we know the slightest change can bring an unwelcomed presence. Did you hear that? That distant noise? You must listen with more than just your ears. You have to your skin, your hair, your teeth, your entire being. For we are here to do more than just provide. We're here to protect all those that we love. So feel just a little bit more myself. Ooh. Bring me back to a time when my mama used to make me help her pick some cotton. And after a long sizzle of a moment, you know that woman told me I had to use last night's bath water that everybody used. But I didn't care. Because that was your feel. Well, when I walked out on the porch, there was Mr. Uncle Joe. He was sitting there rocking. Well, he took one look at me and said, "Ooh, wait, girl, you grown up in a pretty life. You look better than your mom. You know what you need to do? You need to just come over here. You need to come over here and sit on my lap. And if you do, I'm going to give you a brand new, shiny, silver piece." Woo! Well, sitting, going and getting a silver piece just for sitting on that old man's lap. Well, that was more than a week of picking cotton, so yeah, I did. Well, let me tell you about Mr. Uncle Jim. He wasn't just old. Baby, he was fat. He was old and he was fat and he was bald and he had no teeth in his mouth and he smelled something off. So after a little while of this lap sitting in the back room, and I said, oh, Uncle Joe, we're going to have to do something better than this. And that evening, my mama was complaining about taxes on a this and taxes on that. And I gave her an idea. Made my own set of man passes. Let's see. So I made up a old man pass. I made myself a fat man tax. I made myself a bald man tax. I made myself a stinky man tax. Because you know that expensive soap? Yeah, it costs a lot of money. And my favorite, and is the married man test. I love that one. Ooh. Yes, I bought myself a buggy with it. Yes. On Saturday, I went into town and I was walking by the dress store window and I stopped. Because in that window was the most prettiest, the fanciest, the best dress I ever saw in my life, and I couldn't move. I just stared and stared at it. I would have done anything to get it. And right then and there, I got myself another idea. What if I became a real fancy lady that wore real fancy dresses? That real fancy means.
And I knew what I had to do, and I did it. I started to read. I started reading everything I could.
I even ordered magazines, those fancy magazines, from the other side of the world.
And every time I came to the post, you know, people would fund me. They'd say, girl, what you reading that thing for? You can't read it. You don't even understand the words. What I would just tell them, you see, I'm looking at the pictures. And the pictures tell me everything I need.
I listen to those fancy radio shows so I can learn to talk right.
I even went to the picture show so I could see how the ladies were standing.
So I could stand right.
And just as I surmised, a higher caliber of gentlemen began a call. So, just because my hands might be a little worn out from my youth, I'm sure you will agree that with a little help from my friends, you're looking right for the light today. Excuse me.
You must
excuse me. It is time for me to prepare for cinema.
I feel cold wind blow. Oh, it's blowing near through. Martha took my baby. Martha took my baby when he was four. The night before they left. My boy.
in my hands. This taste of...
Everybody talking about how we're free. Everybody talking about how we're free. And they saying, Mama, you need to go north.
Mama, you need to go north and start a new life. Start a new life up nowhere. How am I supposed to leave?
Hush your mouth. Go away. Mama look at boo-boo there. Hush your mouth. Go away. Mama look at boo-boo there. I wonder why nobody love me. Maybe because I'm sexy. Ha ha! Come back to me and say, Miss Carlolou, Miss Carlolou, tell us about life. Tell me about life. You've seen a lot. And I go, maybe this one just a little bit smarter than the rest. So I say, come girl. Come over here with your hot ass and sit that hot ass down. You want to know? You want to know how I done it? Okay. Well, it's true that I've been and I've seen and I've done it all. I've been through a hurricane and a heat wave, a flood and a famine. No man in sight. And all kinds of man. All kinds of colors too. That love to climb this mountain right here. And it never gets in the way. That's a grown-up lady trick. There's been lots and lots of birthdays. All kinds of birthdays. But there was, I raised my kids and I raised his kids. And street kids. And grandbabies, ooh. They're so sweet, you know, those grandbabies. And then they grow up to be teenagers. I've gone through so many teenage things that now, every time I hear another story, I go, aye! Because my hair go bing when it turn gray now. Yes, there was birthdays, but there were another funerals too. And oh baby, they were waves, and they were beaten. But we don't need to talk about that this day. Not this day. You wanted to know how I done it. Well, the answer is so easy and so hard. You want to know? Just keep just keep smiling, baby, because life is still sweet life, and every day you open up those big beautiful brown eyes every day. Anything is possible. And I am living proof to that. Yes! Oh! Ha ha!
Say, don't you touch my temple. Oh no, I see. show me. That was the lessons that they taught me. That was the journey that they took me on in my dark place. And sometimes I wonder, was my mother there with them? Was my mother there in the darkness with the art of the pennies to guide me? Is that what the pennies mean that I still find every day? What I do know, and what I would love to share with all of you, is that every time you find a penny now, it just might be this little.